The buzz from an electrical arc is one of the last things you want to hear while working near an energized source. Not only are they extremely dangerous, they happen so fast, it's nearly impossible to get away from them. However, understanding what they are and how they're formed can help you prevent them from happening. When electricity runs through a conductor, the air around it acts as an insulator, which keeps the path of electricity contained inside the conductor. So an electrical arc is formed when that insulation breaks down. The arc can be short in duration, like static electricity, or it can be longer, creating a continuous arc. Take a look at this arc in slow motion. Enough energy is being supplied to the air that the air's atoms are breaking apart into charged particles, which is a process known as ionization. So much energy is being applied to the air's atoms that the electrons are no longer stable and start to jump from one atom to another. This movement of electrons is the flow of electricity, which in this case is the visible arc. As electrons move, they create a path for electricity to flow. We know that electricity takes the path of least resistance. So once the insulation factor of the air is broken down, it creates an easy path for electricity to continue flowing. If you look closely, you can see the arc pulsing. Each pulse is one cycle of alternating current, and because this is a 60 Hz system, 60 of these happen every second. The brightness of the arc is caused by the high temperatures created by the flow of electric current. Since heat rises, you can see that the arc moves upward, which eventually causes it to break apart. The sound is created by the quick expansion of the heated air around the arc, creating pressure that produces a sound wave. This pressure is so intense that if it happened in an enclosed space, it could have an effect similar to that of dynamite. Weather conditions can cause electrical arcs to be even more dangerous. Take this windy day, for example. Not only does the arc travel upward, but it also responds to the wind's direction, moving up the line to the dead-end shoe. Take into consideration that a nearby worker may start off at a safe distance, but as the wind blows, the arc could move towards them and potentially cause a fatal injury. Electrical arcs are dangerous, but they're almost always preventable. Make sure to obey your minimum approach distances and always use an adequate amount of cover-up.